Sup? Guess I haven't done this in over a year, and this is my second take, because the first one was quite awful. I hope you people had a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. So yeah, December is quite eventful for me. So to begin the whole update thing, let me tell you the bad news, starting with Lost Legends. The 9th episode of Lost Legends, Turok Evolution, is supposed to be released in November. Obviously, November and December came and went, so what happened? Well, we made some changes to the script, and it's far bigger than I initially wrote. The script is so big that I have to split this into two parts. Part 1 focuses on the history, the game, and the playable builds available, and Part 2 will focus on the pre-release materials and cut content. This includes some never-before-seen content that's not surfaced on the internet. Yet. In case you're wondering why I said we, this marks the first episode of the show with collaboration. No, it's not with Matt McMuscles or Digino Gaming, but an individual who is an expert and archivist of this piece of Turok history. Dynomite, now known as the Evolution Archive. In terms of progress, we're halfway done. Well, actually, part 1 is already complete, but part 2, on the other hand, is still on its scripting stage. Yes. Both parts will be uploaded simultaneously, with part 1 being on Rabbit and part 2 being on Dynamites, respectively. Since progress has gotten so slow, I decided to move on with the next episode, which I tackle 3D Pinball, Space Cadet. This, I admit that this is the filler episode, but I need to tell you that there's something a little more than just a packing game for Windows XP. This would have been released by last month, but I lost my work for this. I'll explain. When I got my new power supply 3 weeks ago, I had a crazy week just to get the whole thing installed. Starting with the thickest cables imaginable and fitting them in a relatively small case. I thought I screwed up and bought the wrong one as I couldn't find a 4-pin cable to fit the CPU plug on the motherboard. Until I realized that the one CPU cable can be split apart into two 4-pin plugs. During the whole installation process, I accidentally knocked one of my hard drives off the workbench, and despite the 20-inch drop of a seemingly bulletproof brick, that's enough to kill it. I told my friends what happened, and one of them gave me the news that that drop displaced the needle inside the HDD, rendering the poor thing unreadable. He's dead, Jim. Luckily, this ain't my 2TB Barracuda drive, which contains everything. What that poor 1TB blue drive had was some gaming soundtracks, raw gameplay footage, Lost Legends graphic assets, and ongoing plus future projects I barely started. Fortunately for the graphics, I kept some backup files in my main HDD which I could remake. What I fully lost from that hard drive was the PSD of the status screen. What I haven't told you until now, I have an external HDD which not only contained the finished videos, but leftover assets, including the status screens which I could recreate with ease. The blue drive didn't cost me anything because this was the main HDD for my previous PC, known as the Black Box, which died out on me in early 2021. I already ordered a new 2TB hard drive off of Amazon, which will be my new project storage. I promise I'll be careful next time.
A weird cut? Don't know what you're talking about.
So with my new PC case, I have plenty of space I could work with. One thing I will do is replace these stock Corsair fans in place of Noctua ones, just like I did with my last case. So why not add some LEDs to it? Well, comparing to the fans, they're not practical, and it's only for show. I may have to wait for my paycheck to weigh in my options. I need some fans that are relatively quiet, more quiet than the ones installed now. By the way, I'm running my PC's fans on quiet mode, and it sounds like I'm running this normally. Once the new hard drive arrives, there's a few ideas swarming in my head. One is an iceberg video, which is a trendy thing for the past couple years. Another is a remake of my Twisted Metal Harbor City videos, but it's gonna have blackjacks, hookers, and a musical number. Or it's just like the original two parts, rewritten with new footage and information. Likely the latter. And one more to announce is Lost Legends Season 2. So after Turok, Pinball, the season finale, and the aforementioned two videos, I start working on the second season. I'm not gonna go deep into the details yet, but I can confirm that Gran Turismo 2 is one of the confirmed episodes. Season 2 will be an improvement of the first, and add a little more. Hopefully the mic issues will be resolved, but I can't guarantee that. I'll have to take a look at the then current episode lineup to see which will make the cut on the upcoming season, and what will be replaced. I mean, last year was a huge deal for Lost Media, which features some of the most sought-after pieces being found. Examples being the pilot episode of Jeopardy, the American Sailor Moon pilot, Sesame Street with Margaret Hamilton, Marble Madness 2, a Mario Kart tech demo, the animatic of the cancelled Popeye film, the original version of Rayman Raving Rabbids, and a truckload of cancelled Duke Nukem games and betas. Truly a great year for Lost Media. For those who want to know where I'm at, I do have a Linktree in the description. For my socials, I do have a Twitter, which I keep until the day it dies, Co-host, which is my fallback social site I barely used, and my Discord server known as the Rabbit's Den, name may change. Literally my emoji dump to post on other servers. If you want to know where I post my art as of recent, I still have my Newgrounds, and recently Inkblot, which is that DeviantArt alternative that actually listened to their people. They also banned AI and NFTs too. Downside is the lack of social interaction, but it's a promising sight nonetheless. One more thing is my Blogspot. This is my art dump slash journal on what's on my mind. I show progress in my artworks like I did on ArtStation, talk about some things, and even one page where I commissioned artists to draw my rabbit OC Vivi. And a few updates to my socials as of recent. You may notice that I closed my DeviantArt back in the end of June. I shut it down due to a lack of interest to keep it going, and then moved on to Wisp for a while, and then abandoned that site due to its major issues. Like it favors tall pictures more than wide ones. Then, I abandoned my ArtStation account during the whole anti-AI protest going on last month. I may return to there soon after the fallout, but not as frequently. That and probably troll AI prompters to show their progress. One last update, which is the most recent, is my alt Twitter account. This was supposed to be the official Lost Legends account, but as you can see, no one's following this account, and made a few sparse posts. So instead of being that, I just turned this into my art blog account. For the better, in my opinion, because if you follow my main Twitter for my art, then it's difficult to find my pieces where it's being buried by my comments, along with some other things. The art blog is just restricted to just my artworks, and I've posted some on that Twitter account at the time of writing. Speaking of art, commissions. I opened this for over a month now and no takers yet, but I've opened up 5 slots. So I could do 3 different types, $15 for the basic sketches, $20, $30, or $50 for the pixel art in 3 different sizes, and $60 for the full shaded render. The currencies are all in USD. Yankee doodles, by the way. You can DM me on my Twitter, Newgrounds, Discord, or even Inkblot. If you message me with Type Rabbit, then it's a 25% discount for any commission I advertise. That's until the end of the month, by the way. For payment, I'm accepting PayPal, so no crypto, NFTs, or Monopoly money. I'll keep you posted for the progress, and feedback is appreciated.
Oh, and read my guidelines before you attempt to make me draw something. There's more details in my Newgrounds page. Links in the description. And that's it. I'm sorry for posting this way late and disorganized than I should. I just wanted to tell you that I have a pulse in not going radio silent on the whole thing. This update was planned to be a bit bigger, but this would have involved the ArtStation AI protest, how the Muskman runs Twitter, and why the higher-ups at YouTube and the Canadian government are the biggest dipshits imaginable. I'd stick to my own battles for now. I just don't want to go into the whole drama and politics of that stuff. And yeah. So stay tuned for this month's Lost Legends, where I cover 3D Pinball, Space Cadet, and then the collaboration with Dynamite on the two-part episode of Turok Evolution, coming soon. And that's all for today, and I'll see you later. Bye.